I've been hunting and fishing in these parts for years. Someone do something!
Can't a woman get... You're not supposed to be here. You're not su- I'm not going to warn you again. Get out, or I'll call the guards.
Being old's not so bad. Daughter keeps me fed, and my working days are done.
You look like you could do with a ripe apple, or a tomato, cabbage, or leek.
Right? That's what you do. Please, take pity. Oh, thank you. Divines bless your kind heart. My master has abandoned me, abandoned his people, and nothing I say can change his mind. Now he refuses to even see me. He says I interrupt his vacation. It's been so many years. Won't you please help? Last I saw him, he was visiting a friend in the Blue Palace. But no one as mundane as the Jarl. No, no. Such people are below him. No, he went into the forbidden wing of the palace to speak with an old friend. Said it had been ages since they had last had tea. Oh, and you'll need the hip bone. It's very important. No entering Pelagius's wing without that. Oh, you just don't understand. Without him, I am not free. Without him, I am doomed. All of his empire shall fall into chaos. All right, then.
Welcome to the Bard's College. I'm the headmaster here.
Always a pleasure to meet a prospective bard. You should be aware that many apply, but we accept very few people. When possible, we ask applicants to perform tasks the college needs completed. In this case, I do have a task befitting an aspiring bard. Elisif has forbidden the burning of King Olaf, a festival put on by the Bard's College. We need to change her mind. To convince her, I want to read King Olaf's verse, a part of the Poetic Edda, the living history of Skyrim. Unfortunately, the verse was lost long ago. Yes, according to Giraud, our history's keeper, the portion of the Edda dealing with King Olaf might still exist in Dead Man's Respite. I need you to retrieve the poem. Not much, but as a bard, I find the whole affair depressing. There are no heroes in this war, no winners to be had, and no real conclusion. If you want something a bard can dig into, look to the dragons. 1,000 years from now, Skyrim will have changed rulers dozens of times, but the return of the dragons, not much, to be honest. Their return was a shock to us all. Gerard Germain has some tomes about them in the library, if you're interested. As you may be aware, Elisif's husband, High King Torig, was recently killed. Elisif mourns her husband deeply, and she feels that a festival that burns a king in effigy is... I tried to convince her the festival is many centuries old and celebrates solitude, but I need proof. I believe King Olaf's verse will provide that proof. I think Giraud here would give you the best explanation of both it and the history of King Olaf's verse. You should speak to him about it.
I wish you luck. Good to meet a prospective bard. He's sending you after King Olaf's verse, then. That's good. We shouldn't leave it lying around now that I've figured out where it is. The verse was Svaknir's contribution to the Poetic Edda, the living history of Skyrim. Each bard adds to the Edda in his or her time, and a very ancient one. The verse criticized the reigning King Olaf. He was so incensed the bard was put to death and all the copies burned. At least, that's what we thought until I translated some ancient texts a year or so ago. We now believe King Olaf buried the truth with the bard. If I'm right, Svaknir and King Olaf's verse lie in Dead Men's Respite, along with the burial chamber of King Olaf himself. Be careful. You might find more than just King Olaf's verse in Dead Man's Respite.
Thank you. is time.
You can afford a septim or two.
You should see me when you get bored, stranger. If you're looking for opportunities to make some coin, well, I'm here.
Heard they're reforming the Dawn Guard. Vampire hunters or something in the old fort near Riften.
I've got some salmon to sell.
Thank you.
you've returned. How goes the task I gave you?
I have to admit, I didn't think it would actually be there. Now, let's take a look at this. Oh, the copy is incomplete. It's on the parts that are readable. Well, Bardic verse has come a long way since it means I can't read it to the court. Without the verse, I won't be able to convince Elisif of the importance of the burning of King Olaf festival. If she isn't convinced of the festival's importance, then she won't reverse her decision to stop the effigy burning. It means that the burning of King Olaf, which the Bard's College has held for time immemorial, won't be happening. Make it up? That doesn't seem... I suppose I could copy his style based on what you brought me, but I have no idea what happened in between these verses. Oh, Olaf, our subjugator, the one-eyed betrayer, death-dealing demon and dragon-killing king, your legend is lies, lurid, and false. Your cunning capture of Numenex.
King Olaf was Olaf One-Eye? He famously captured the dragon Numenex and took him to Dragon's Reach. What did we say really happened?
I find that highly unlikely, but the court will love it. I'm writing it in.
Olaf grabbed from Falkreath, but solitude stood strong. Olaf's vengeance was instant, inspired, and wicked.
Strange. According to history, solitude attacked Winterhold, but Asgeir seemed to be saying Olaf reacted. What do we say happened? No, that's pushing it too far. It's very exciting, but highly unlikely. I can't possibly write that in. It's not the most exciting answer, but the most likely. I'll write it in. It has a few final lines, but that's all we needed to add. I need to head to court immediately and present this. You should come. I do hope the court likes the verse. I think we've done an excellent job of recreating it. We should really get to court.